Christmas, and thank you for coming out to see our videos. My video in particular is Unmatched, and this is my first project. I had a lot of help. Man, it was rough, but I got there, and it inspired me to create more. Hopefully in the future, I will have tons and tons more video, more professionally made, with more experience. I hope you enjoy. Then to everyone, Merry Christmas, and to the end of 2021, peace.
Hey man, what are you doing?
Hey listen, don't judge me, all right? I'm on a dating website.
Oh, man, I'm on a few of those.
Oh, hey, so what are you doing?
I'm on a dating site right now.
Really?
Yep.
So that's where we're at?
Yeah. That's where we're at right now. So, but I did see someone that was kind of like,
okay.
Okay.
let me see. I would say you could.
Yeah. I would say this is acceptable.
Okay.
Yeah.
Say hi.
Alright.
Gotta wait for the response. Look like you might have a message right there.
Okay.
I'll just send him a picture. Should I also send him my number?
I mean, I guess if you want. This kind of seems like a strike though.
Okay.
That's just my opinion. You can do you. Okay, if you want to send him your number, I mean, just block him. If worst comes to worst.
I mean,
right?
Yeah. You're right. Okay, I'll just send him my number.
Ooh, I got that one from a mortician, man.
Ooh,
she drop dead gorgeous. Hey, I think you're really cute. Here's my number. You should give me a call sometime.
So, what you think? Are you going to call her?
I don't know, man. Should I get a picture of her? Make sure she's real?
Yes. That sounds like something I do.
All right, let's see. Send me a different picture so I know you're not catfishing. Alright, there's her other picture.
Ooh.
I'll send her another picture of me. What you think of them Speedos? You like them?
I like a good pitch, but them Speedos, I don't know, but you know, I guess it'll do.
Yeah. She said no, LOL. You should definitely give that number a call though, and maybe we can talk. I should call her? Should I send her my number?
He just sent you back his number?
Yeah. I said to call me. But he says he's busy. What is this?
I don't get that. I don't understand. That doesn't make sense to me. If he's busy, how does you calling him change the fact that he's busy?
You didn't use my number? Oh, looks like she got a little attitude there. You ain't call her.
Hey man, I'm not for a girl with an attitude.
Exactly. I don't know. That seems like small dick energy.
I don't know, man. She kind of has a big forehead. I could land a plane on that forehead, dude. I don't know how I feel about that.
She's just like, I don't even need a shirt on. I don't even need a pants on. What? I'm just going to leave my socks and my undies.
I could kick a field goal between them teeth. And I don't...
He's the type of person who wears socks in bed.
And that picture of you and them tidy whities that you just sent her, I don't know. She might be thinking the same thing about you.
That's embarrassing.
Yeah, it looked like she might just be a nagger.
Okay.
You know what? Not it.
Blocked. Yeah. Blocked. Well, I gotta get to class. I'll see you later. I gotta go.
All right.
See you later.
It looks like y'all about to get into a war of words already. And it seemed like how a good thing just goes bad so sudden. Yeah. So it's on you. I'm gonna sit here and let you figure that out, and I'm just about to go get me a cup of old man's Java.
All right, man.
Hot chocolate.
Yeah, thanks for your advice.
All right.
Ruben Alspaw Smith, and this is my video. I hope you all enjoy it, and I'd like to thank my classmates and Mr. Emerson for making it possible. It's basically a music video. It's called Aesthetic Speaks My Name, and I hope you enjoy it. As a child, Lord, I feel so sad. I stand so idly, looking over my head. Like Smith hoping for me, this fate I will accept. I see death slowly creeping. about to kick the chair. No, I ain't ashamed. Aesthetic speaks my name. Aesthetic speaks my name. Dear God.
My name is Haley Morgan, and I play the abusive wife in one of the dead bodies in Till Death Do Us Part. And I would like to give a personal shout out to the director for picking me for this part. It was really an honor, boosted my self-esteem, especially as the abusive wife being one of the leads. It was very difficult for me to portray the abusive wife because in my life, I'm neither physically or verbally abusive. Now, sexually abusive on occasion. No, I'm just kidding. Just a joke. It was very hard, though, seriously, to play that part. Being the dead body, there's a funny story with that, but I'm sure you'll hear all about it from the director since, you know, you're meeting him. So, that's all. Thank you for watching Till Death Do Us Part.
Hi, my name is Charlton Cole Hester. I'm the director of Till Death Do Us Part. This trailer for a movie, obviously, follows an abusive wife who pushes her husband to the edge and causes him to go out and kill the women. And I'd like to give a shout out to all my friends and family that helped me make this video. It has been a great time, and I've loved every second of it. Filmmaking is what I want to do in my life as my career. And this has definitely opened my eyes up to some of the challenges and obstacles that are going to be in my way. But I've loved every second of it. And I really hope that y'all enjoy Till Death Do Us Part. Thank you.
My name is Emmacary Chalez, and I'm about to present my video project for this semester for my film class today. I worked really hard with my classmates who helped me and my instructor, Mr. Emerson. So thank you, and I hope you guys enjoy my video.
Last presentation done.
Thank you. My name is Lagan Gangwani, and I made a documentary about why I think we should stop eating fast food. Growing up, I was very overweight, and I was picked on because of how overweight I was. I think it's unfair that fast food companies have bad quality meat, and they still charge it cheap and tell people it's safe to eat when it's not. So, I think in my documentary, I presented enough evidence for people to make their own decisions and see how these big corporations really don't care about people. They only care about making money. However, there is hope for the future. During the lockdown in 2020, fast food sales actually went down. But you watch it and you make up your own mind. Peace.
He followed Ronald and Grimace that day and tried to take their burgers away. But he couldn't have them. Don't think small,
go for it all. Someday I'm gonna make it big. Think big, think that big.
The value of the dollar keeps going down, year by year. I'd like to ask the question, why are we still eating fast food? When McDonald's started in 1940, a hamburger was 15 cents. Today, in 2021, 15 cents is equivalent to $2.96. How is it McDonald's can sell hamburgers at $1 a piece?
We showed you last week how the government is changing nutritional rules for school lunches. Los Angeles is already changing its school menus after a challenge from a famous television chef.
As Bill Whitaker reports, he's also taking on some fast food giants and winning.
Okay, this is not fit for human consumption.
Celebrity chef and food activist Jamie Oliver is a man on a mission to stop the use of what he calls pink slime. Beef scraps no one would choose to eat, reprocessed and repurposed for use in hamburger patties.
We're taking a product that would be sold at the cheapest form for dogs.
And after this process,
we can give it to humans.
The first salvo in his high-profile food fight, this stomach-turning demonstration on his TV show, Food Revolution, 9 months ago.
We're gonna wash these lean bits of beef in a water and ammonia solution.
Ammonium hydroxide, to be exact, to kill off bacteria. It's all FDA approved.
This is a practice that is openly sort of admitted to being in at least 70% of ground beef products.
Maybe because it's actually the worst quality beef on planet Earth. In 2011, McDonald's was exposed for having ammonium hydroxide in their burgers. So what is ammonium hydroxide? Ammonium hydroxide is a solution found in chemical fertilizers and also found in stuff such as window cleaning. Ingestion of ammonium hydroxide can cause vomiting, nausea, and gastric pain. Now, the scary part of all this is to think about, had they not been caught, had nobody found this out, McDonald's most likely would have still been using it. Hell, they probably still are. They're probably just using a different variation so they get away with it after this was so well documented. And I don't claim to be the healthiest person alive. I don't. In fact, on the contrary, especially growing up, I was addicted to fast food. And I can remember when I was very young, I would drink a lot of soda. And I was very overweight throughout my childhood. In conclusion, you can make your own decisions, but I believe I have presented enough evidence to you for you to see that McDonald's burgers, burgers at restaurants in general, is just going to continue to get worse and worse and worse, both in the quality and in the ingredients. But if you do like McDonald's burgers, don't feel bad. Because last Saturday, I had cookout for lunch and dinner. So peace.
Hi, my name is Angelica Webster. I am a digital effects and animation major. So through this film, it was really important for me to incorporate animation into my film. Because of that, animation is kind of a long process, and while I definitely did get a bunch of animation into the short film, it did take a lot longer than I anticipated, so my original idea is not quite where it is now. But even so, I had a great time editing the entire process. I was able to learn a bunch of new techniques and really try to make something that I could put on a portfolio, or at least something fairly close to being portfolio worthy. I really enjoyed the making of this video, so I really hope that that enjoyment is passed on to you guys. Thanks. Space.
space. Travel through the clouds and saw the world a different way.
Hi guys, I am Marina Reagan Zealy. I am 42-year-old student, soon to be graduate here at Forsyth Tech Community College, and I am a Videography 2 student in Professor Emerson's class. So we had an entire pandemic occur during my last year here at Forsyth Tech. So during that time, I really got to hone my green screen skills during that pandemic that I learned in Videography 1 on Adobe Premiere Cut Pro. And basically what I started doing was using my skills as a wigstress and makeup artist and stylist and drag artist and all of the above to start making and playing my own characters and creating this world. And I created a web series called Quarantine with Geraldine. And the Geraldine character is basically an amalgam of, like, all the strong Southern women that I have in my family. And basically covers all these odd scenarios that she finds herself in, where I was playing all the other characters as well, and able to do all of this by using green screen and Premiere Cut Pro. So upon doing Videography 2, I knew already that I wanted to do a short Geraldine film. I knew that I wanted to take the Geraldine character and put her on a different platform, so to speak. And that's what I was able to do, this year. And I even made my own little, theatrical trailer, and I hope you guys enjoy it. This is called The Gingersnap Sisters, and it's an origin story of sorts of the Geraldine character and the world that she lives in. And I hope you guys enjoy it.
The phone's ringing. Hold your horses, Vita Marie. I'm a coming. Hi, sis. Hey, sissy. how you doing? God damn it, Earl, I done told you several times now. Today is my only hair salon appointment with my sister.
Oh, goddamn Corbin.
I'll be damned if you're gonna bother me today. I've been rocking this horrible excuse for a DIY beehive this entire damn pandemic, and it will be a cold day in hell with Hitler passing out popsicles to children before you take this day away from me.
Goddamn mukbang, bitch. Goddamn mukbang, bitch.
I don't give a good goddamn. Damn! Get up off your fat ass and fix it yourself!
I don't give a damn. I don't give a hee-haw.
Shit! How'd you guess? Of course he forgot we had an appointment today. I don't know what I see in him either. Nowadays, I'm lucky if I can even see past his fat ass. It's a classic case of marrying a good lay that aged about like Greek yogurt. Of course you don't mean no offense. Anyway, speaking of which, Mama always did used to say to consider the source, how's single life treating you, Shug? Still watching true crime marathons while you eat Lunchables with your 13 cats? Done struck a nerve there, didn't I, Shug? I know. Them Lunchables have been the only ways you've been able to count calories since your lap band. I'm such a what? A what? Say it. Oh, come on. I know you want to. Go on and let the devil use you today. Oh, okay. You know what, Vita Marie? Ever since you found the Lord, you've gotten real damn boring. Oh, you call it peaceful, do you, honey? Well, tomato, tomato, honey. Well, I reckon I'll see you there too, Shug. I can't wait for us to finally have our annual beauty shop appointment together after this horrible pandemic. Oh, it's gonna be so nice, just me and you and Master Stylist Smoochie in the salon. I'll see you in a few, sissy. Bye. I don't care if it's your daddy's lot. It's my modular, and almost all the dryer chairs is mine.
I tried to bring a dryer chair, Smoochie.
A portable dryer cap, duct taped to a high chair, don't count as a salon dryer chair, Corbell.
Semantics.
I don't even care at this. Why are you even here today? You know this is my day with Vita Marie and Geraldine.
Well, as you well know, Smoochie, one of my celebrity clients got a promotion to be the weather girl on the news, and I had to fit her in today. I didn't have much of a choice.
I'm assuming when you're referring to celebrity client, you're talking about Pauline. I hardly consider the local news air traffic reporter of Boogertown, North Carolina, to be a celebrity client, Bill.
Correction. She's the new weather girl of Boogertown, North Carolina.
Oh.
Smoochie, it was beyond my control. My celebrity clients got a brand new gig, and I just had to fit her in today.
Great. Now I got a second reason not to watch them.
Second? What's the first?
Is Pauline still married to Banks, the lead anchor?
Well, I think so, yeah.
Ask him. Geraldine, Vita!
Smoochie?
Oh, Smoochie. My eyes had better not be deceiving me.
You have to forgive me. I promise you I have an explanation.
What is that raggedy bitch Corbell Jenkins doing here?
I just can't tell you how sorry I am, Geraldine. I know that for years you and Vita Marie's appointments have been faithful and like clockwork at the same time every week. But apparently Pauline got a promotion to weather girl at work and just insisted that she had to come in today. Geraldine, why don't we start with you today? Go on ahead and get yourself in there and get yourself situated. Vita Marie, is that okay with you?
Thank you, Sissy.
So, just out of complete curiosity, Vita Marie, just exactly how did this whole feud between y'all and Pauline start?
Well, growing up, we sang together in a gospel group, and our big break was at the Grand Ole Opry, and we were singing our hit single, Get Your Hands Up Off Me.
Get your hands off of him, it don't belong to you. Get your hands off of him, it don't belong to you. He's my own mind, no matter what you do. Now you can stare and wonder just what his love is like. Get your hands off of him, unless you want a big fight.
Get your hands off of him.
Center stage and started just a clogging and just kind of turned the party, I guess the kids say. And, well, she got the contract and that was that.
Now you can stare and wonder just what his love is like. Get your hands off of him unless you want a big fight.
Get your hands off of him. He don't belong to you. He's my
well, imagine that pretty much sawed off Geraldine, and well, that was that.
Well, that explains a whole lot. Speaking of which, how about we better go on inside in there before Geraldine strings up Corabelle and Pauline?
So, you know, I think the rooted blonde is the new look.
I think it is too. All those girls on the morning shows, they have it. And I think being the first female weather person here in Boogertown, I need to rock them roots. And plus, Banks likes the root.
He does like a little rootedness now, honey.
Remember when he had them tips?
Girl, honey, frosted.
And Ryan Seacrest tried to copy.
Running around telling everybody they was guy-like.
I am. Love it.
Oh, Lord, honey. So you know Geraldine was fussing.
She's always fussing.
She's bothered about your appointment.
She needs to recognize that she can go to church. I'll get my hair done.
Well, you know. Yeah.
Well, I appreciate you keeping a celebrity seat open all the time.
You know, I have to do what I have to do for my client.
And you're so good. I'll give you a shout out on 6 o'clock.
I appreciate that.
right after
oh,
the weather.
Oh, my goodness, honey.
Yeah.
Geraldine, it's okay. Don't mind her shoes. Let's go ahead and get you draped, and then we can get started.
I don't want to wear the cape right now. Just do what you do, Smoochie.
It's all right. It's up to you, Shug. I'm just going to take a little bit off the back here and tease it on.
I'm desperately in need. This DIY beehive is in desperate need of your love and touch, honey.
You can say that again.
What did I say to that bitch?
Corbell Jenkins, I'm going to tell you what. You better get your client.
So anyways, how'd you get the news about being the new weather girl of Boogertown?
Banks told me. Well, you know, they had that young guy from Charlotte coming out here for about 2 years, and, well, they had to get rid of him. I'm not sure exactly why, but he's gone.
I could make a couple guesses.
Anyway, when he left, I let Banks know that I was the only choice to replace him to become...
That's logical.
Yeah, to become the first female weather person in Boogertown.
We needed it too, honey. Geraldine, she means Banks has always employed men as his anchors. What do you think inspired him to hire Boogertown, North Carolina's first weather woman that just so happens to be his wife?
Well, you know, first of all, born and raised right here in Boogertown, and I mean, I'm a weather girl. I'm hair for all weather, everything. And, you know, I just was the perfect choice for the job. And plus, he loves having me with him all the time at work and at home.
Yeah, because he don't hardly ever stay at home.
Just because your husband's sitting there running around town doing all this stuff doesn't mean everybody else's does the same. Mine is fine doing what he does. Look, your husband is the dirty, good-for-nothing philanderer running around doing all kinds of things behind your back, but we ain't gonna talk about that. You wanna bring my husband into it.
Dirty, good-for-nothing? Let's go on ahead and unpack that, shall we? Earl might be a dirty philanderer, but at least he still comes home to touch me at night.
He ain't the only thing he's touching at night all over town. It's
Pauline,
true.
Girl.
Film at 11.
Oh, Pauline, why did you have to go there?
It's okay, Vita Marie. We've known for a long time now that just because she's kin don't mean that she's our sister. Speaking of cheating men, according to Smoochie, your husband Banks spends an awful lot of time at the Boogertown rest stop, and we all know what that means.
That is absolutely ridiculous. We all know how theatrical and melodramatic your kind of people can be.
My kind of people? What the hell is that supposed to mean,
You know
Pauline?
Exactly what I mean. You know exactly what I mean, Smoochie.
Well, I suppose you would know better than anybody, wouldn't you, Pauline?
What's that supposed to mean?
Just what he said.
Y'all, this is getting real ugly. I really think we should just pray together and just try to forgive one another and try to understand where we're all coming from.
Oh, shut the hell up, Edward. Get off that cross with that Southern Baptist holier-than-thou bullshit you're doing. The only reason you became one of them church girls was so you get that congregation to pay for that lap band surgery that clearly didn't take.
Ooh. That's it? How dare you talk about my lap band! This is precisely why we don't talk to you no more. Because you're a miserable, hateful old bitch whose husband is gayer than a hot pink poodle in the Easter parade in South Beach at a Judy Garland concert. You want to talk about what everybody in town knows, Pauline? Everybody in town knows that Banks is kicking his heels up to high heaven to every Tom, Dick, and Harry in town, including Timmy the weather boy, which is the only reason you got that job, so you could keep being his beer. Well, you're not gonna talk to my celebrity client this way today. You know what? I will talk to my sister any damn way I please, and you will mind your own damn business. You can use that mouth for what you normally use that mouth for, Corbell Jenkins, you hootenanny harlot whore husband stealing tramp.
Oh my gosh. Now, we have tried to be nice. We have tried to be polite. We have tried to pray. We've even tried to read scripture.
You've tried to baptize me with that spit.
Clearly, it ain't working.
I just love it when you let the devil use you, Vita Marie. Now, Pauline, why don't you take some notes from good old Corbell Jenkins over there and find you a man that actually wants to touch you? Maybe, just maybe, if you got the cobwebs dusted off that dry ass pussy, you wouldn't be such a nasty, hateful bitch. Celebrity, my ass. Pauline, what? You done scared off my celebrity client.
Bye.
Hold the glory.
Ta-da.
Master Stylist Smoochie, you have done it again.